Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. On today's episode, let's look at how to get around autocorrect so you could type a word that's not in the dictionary on your iPhone or iPad. So I get asked this a lot. You want to type something on your iPad or your iPhone, but it's not a real dictionary word. Maybe it's somebody's last name or it's the name of a company or something like that that's not in the dictionary. How do you get it to not autocorrect? And the problem is that you start typing something. So let's say I'm going to type a word that's not a real word here, but maybe it's somebody's last name. And you can see if I were to press the space bar, it's going to change QWE to a real word, aw. And I don't want that. So how do I get around that? Well, if I start typing QWE, notice at the top I've got three buttons that are suggestions. The one in the center is the one that my iPad really believes is the one I want to type. And if I hit the space bar, it's going to go and insert that one in there instead of what I have typed. This is great if you've misspelled a word. On the right, I see another suggestion. So there's two suggestions there. I could use that second suggestion, QWERTY, by just simply tapping QWERTY. I can also use AW by simply tapping AW and it would change the word and insert a space. But notice on the left I've got in quotes QWE. It's basically giving me the option to use what I've typed verbatim without changing it. So if I want to use QWE, instead of hitting space which will change the word to AW, I simply tap where it says quote QWE quote. And you can see then it goes and says, okay, I'll use your word even though it's not in my dictionary. And I'll insert in space and let you start typing the next word. So that's how you go and use a word that's not in the dictionary. Basically going around the autocorrect function. Now often when I tell people about this, they say that they don't see those three buttons above their keyboard. And it looks like this instead. They have a thick line and a little white dash above the Y. And this means they've collapsed those extra keyboard tools. And if you didn't know they were there in the first place, then you may have a lot of trouble figuring out how to get it back. How to get it back is you tap and drag slightly upward where that white dash is above the Y. And it will just bring up those tools again. So now you've got those three buttons back. And you've got some extra tools to the left and the right side of the keyboard that change depending on which app you're using. But usually you'll see those three buttons there. And now as you type something, you'll be able to use the left button to select what you have typed verbatim without having it autocorrect.